Hello, scientific writers. In today's video, we are going to talk about open access. What we'll do is compare the traditional publishing model to the open access publishing model, because there are some factors that you need to be aware of when you are choosing a target journal to submit your research for publication. Hi, it's Brian from the Grants and Publications YouTube channel. Thanks for joining us today. Let's first talk about the traditional publishing model. In this model, the authors of a scientific paper can submit it to the journal and publish it for free. They don't have to pay anything. So where does the journal make its money? In the traditional model, the journal is making its money or its profit from subscription fees. Subscription fees are being paid by individual subscribers or from university libraries or company libraries that might subscribe to these journals. And when you submit your paper to the journal and you publish it for free, in the traditional model, the journal then owns the copyright to that publication. So that's an important consideration for some people. Do you want to have control of the copyright, or do you want to hand that over to the journal? Now, there are some problems with this traditional publishing model. The first one is that not all universities can afford to subscribe to every journal. Thus, sometimes students, faculty, or staff don't have ready access to the research articles that they need for their own research, so they don't have access. In that case, somebody's going to have to pay for access to that journal article. So I'm sure you've seen when you click onto an article and it's behind a paywall, the website says pay this fee and you'll get access to the article. That's one way to do it. University libraries also have a network where they can request articles from other libraries, and they have to pay to do that. So either the scientist is going to pay, or the scientist's employer is going to pay to get access to that article that the university library does not have. I have another video on how to get articles that are behind a paywall, so I'll link to that up here. A second problem with the traditional publishing model is for people like me that are not currently affiliated with any university, I can't go to my university library and ask for access. So I have to pay out of my pocket, or I have to find some other way to get that article. And most of the research is being funded through grants from federal institutions like the NIH, the NSF, the Department of Energy, the Department of Agriculture, Department of Defense. And these are taxpayer dollars. And then the taxpayers can't see the results of the research that their money is funding. So that's kind of a problem for society. The third problem of the traditional publishing model that I would like to bring up, I've already brought up earlier, and that is the issue of copyright. So you sign over your copyright to the journal, and then that means you can't freely distribute your article because you don't own the copyright to it. Even though you wrote it, now you don't have ownership anymore. So you can't just give the article to anybody that asks for it legally, and you can't legally publish it on your webpage. Now, there are some exceptions to this. Certain traditional publishers will let you distribute your article by PDF after an embargo period. Sometimes that's a year. Or they might allow you to archive a different version of the article, like a pre-publication version, for example. Sometimes journals allow you to use your article in certain ways, but they do own the copyright. Now, people recognized these problems with the traditional publishing model, and that's where the open access model originated, was to address some of these problems. So what open access means is that anyone with an internet connection can download and read and distribute any of the publications in an open access journal. So it's free for the readers. You don't have to pay that access fee. The university library doesn't have to pay an access fee. It's free to you as a reader. In terms of copyright, typically the author retains the copyright when they publish with open access because the articles are made available under a Creative Commons license. And so that license allows anyone to freely use that article in any way they want to, as long as they attribute the authors of that article. Also, because the authors retain the copyright, you can archive the article any way you want to. You can put it on your website, you can put it on your university's website, you can email it to all your friends. Anything you want to do with it, you're allowed because you still have the copyright as the author. And so self-archiving of the final version is allowed, as opposed to the traditional publishing model where self-archiving is usually not the final version, it's usually a pre-publication version. But one of the big drawbacks of open access is that the authors have to pay to publish. So in the traditional model, it was free for the authors to publish. In the open access model, the authors have to pay to publish most of the time. There are some exceptions, and we'll get to that. So the authors pay what is known as an APC, article processing charge. And the article processing charge is anywhere from typically $1,000 up to more than $10,000. On average, we're looking at around $2,800 to $3,000 US dollars in 2021 as the average article processing charge to publish open access. So it's pretty expensive. Where does this money come from? Well, at certain universities, the department or the institution has some funds they set aside to pay for a certain number of open access publications. The authors might get the money from a grant that they have been awarded, or they find the money somewhere else. I suppose there are times when the authors pay out of their pocket. Now, a lot of open access publishers will give discounts or even free 100% discounts to authors that are in certain developing countries. So if you're in one of those countries, check with your target journal and see if you can get a discount or even a 100% discount. All right, so we've talked about what open access is compared to the traditional publishing model, but there are different types of open access. The first type is the one that I've just been talking about. It's the pay-to-publish model, also known as gold open access. So with these gold open access journals, authors have to pay to publish, but there are no subscription fees. You can access it by yourself. You don't have to go through the university. The gold open access journals are fully open access. So every article in them is open access. Now, another type of open access journal is called the hybrid journal. So the hybrid journals, open access is optional. You can publish in the traditional model where it's free for you, but it's not free for the readers, or you can publish in the open access model where the author pays and then it is free for the readers. Then there's another type of access called green open access. And green open access doesn't really depend on the journal's business model, whether it's gold or a hybrid. What green open access means is that the article is put into a repository where anyone can access that article for free. If you want to find out more about these repositories, I have a link in the description, so go and check that. It's a link to the OpenDOAR or the Open Directory of Open Access Repositories, and you can look for the repository in your country. A fourth model of open access is called the diamond model. So diamond open access journals are free for the readers, and they're also free for the authors. The authors don't have to pay, the readers don't have to pay. Who has to pay? Somebody has to pay because there are costs associated with running a website, with processing the articles and publishing them and maintaining all of that infrastructure. With diamond open access, it's paid for by donors. So the donors might be institutions like universities or foundations, or they might be individuals that decide to donate some money for these diamond open access journals. I have another video on how to choose a target journal. So I give you a number of considerations that you need to think about as you are deciding where to submit your manuscript. And I will link to that up here. So let's talk about the positives and negatives of open access publishing as compared to traditional publishing. One of the positives is there are no cost for readers. And so open access journals typically have a higher citation rate than non-open access journals. It's not a huge difference, but there is a difference. Another positive, because everyone has free access to this article, the people that are ultimately funding the research, the taxpayers of that country, have access to the results that come out of the research. So it's better for society. The negatives of open access, One of them is that it's expensive. It costs a lot of money for the authors. When I was a professor and I had my own research lab, there were times when I didn't have grant money, but I needed to publish something. So I had to find some funds in my budget, divert them from research supplies into publishing fees. It was a hardship for my lab. If there are scientists that are between grants or they don't have funding for publication for some reason, it can be a hardship for them. And they might not be able to use open access. They might have to go with the traditional publishing model. Now, a negative is kind of the other side of the coin. When I mentioned that taxpayers have access to the research that they funded, that's true, but now they have to pay for the publication fees too. So it's actually going to be inflationary on grant proposals. So as open access becomes more and more prominent and researchers are writing open access fees into their grant proposals, the price is going to keep going up and up. And I have another video talking about those issues, and I'll link to that right here. A third negative for publishing open access, even if you go the free route in the Diamond Open Access journals, they're not very well known and or they have a low impact factor. Now, maybe that will change and Diamond Open Access will take off and the impact factors will increase. I hope that's true. So if impact factor is something that's important to you, the Diamond Open Access Journal may not meet that need. Well, I hope you got some useful information and value from this video. If so, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to the Grants and Publications YouTube channel if you want to hear more videos about scientific writing related topics. All of my sources for this video can be found in the description, so take a look at those. I'll see you next time and happy writing.